So we're going to be talking about the scanning system on a shopping cart right now. We've got the scanner here on this side. We've got the display to show you your running total. And we have the remove button, which we'll demonstrate in a second. Okay, I'm going to turn it on.
Just putting power.
And should display say something like, hello world. You can change that to say, welcome to the store, or whatever. So, then it gives you the total. The running total. So, we have a database in the microcontroller with all the different barcodes and their corresponding prices. We're going to be using a few things that we've already put into the database. So, this one is a Cheez-Its box barcode. And when we scan it, it should come up on the display, give you the price. We've got a flat rate box. And we're gonna scan that in. And it'll give you the price. We've got the Simulink book. Scan this guy in, and it'll just give you the price on here. So now our total looks like it's $43.93 with all the stuff that we're gonna buy. We can also use this button to remove an item in case we decide we don't want to buy that anymore. So we push this button, and it'll say remove mode on the screen. So then what you do is, I'm gonna take the Simulink book again, scan it in, it'll subtract that price from the total. So now we're back down to $4. When you scan an item, we're going to be scanning the Smith's Rewards card, scanning an item that has an unknown barcode, it'll say on this display, it'll just say unknown item, and it'll give you the number right here. So we've got 450-455-332636. And so when we scan it, it should just come up right on the display. Yeah, 450, and there it is. And it won't add it to the total because it's an unknown item. Okay. Okay, so now we're going to demonstrate the movement part of the shopping cart. We have Tyler here holding the IR source. And what's going to happen is the camera sees the IR source, adjusts the movement of the motors. Okay. So we'll start that. So right now we turn on the left, right, and the front, back.
This Prince song inside my head. Hands up if you're down to get down tonight, 'cause it's always a good time. Slept in all my clothes.
Okay, so the next thing we'll demonstrate is the 18-inch bubble. Tyler's gonna back up. The cart's going to move, and when it gets within the specified range, the cart will just stop.
Good morning, girl.
It's gonna be alright. We don't even have to try. It's always a good time.
Okay, so the whole objective of the shopping cart is to have the consumer be able to wear the IR source so that you can just naturally walk right in front of it without having to stand in front of it like this. So we're gonna have Tyler demonstrate this. So now we're going to to demonstrate the seatbelt part of this project. We're gonna have Tyler make the cart move. We'll stop the cart, unplug the seatbelt, and try it again, and you'll notice that it doesn't move. We'll plug it back up, and it should work again. So, okay. Hold it higher. So it moves. Okay, stop for a second. So now we're gonna unplug the seatbelt. And so Tyler put the camera, or put the light source in front of it again.
You can hear the brakes.
Okay, and now we plug the seatbelt back in. And moves again. Okay, so now we're gonna demonstrate the sensor part of our project. We're gonna have the shopping cart follow me, and I will walk kind of towards the wall, and we'll see the shopping cart recognize that it's getting within the 18-inch bubble, and it will push away from the wall.